Good day. It's good to have you with us for just this brief announcement. We wanted to touch base with you and in any format we possibly can. We tried it a little bit earlier with Facebook Live, but our internet signal kind of made things a little bit choppy. So we are hoping that this will work a little bit better. We want you to know, first and foremost, we are open on Sunday. This stay-at-home order is not going to affect our ability to gather as a church, and we are experiencing the capacity limitations, but we want you to know we're open. So we will be holding services at 9 and 11, and we'll be having our Bible classes at 10 o'clock on Sunday morning, and so we encourage you to come. Once the sanctuary is full with our limitations, we will be utilizing our overflow capacity, which means that we have two rooms set up with closed-circuit television and with physical distancing, and so we encourage you to come and be a part of that. Second thing we want you to be aware of is that all of our small groups will be continuing as planned. The only change is that one of the ladies' groups that was being led by Georgina Wisby is being canceled due to the fact that Georgie is experiencing some health problems right now. And so we want you to be praying for her, but that group will instead be taken into a group led by Geraldine Lackey, which meets Tuesdays at 1 o'clock. And so if you're a part of Georgie's group, please know that you are moved from Monday evening to Tuesday afternoon. Our men's group will be meeting as scheduled tonight at 7 o'clock, led by Larry McLaren. The subject matter is the principles of prayer, and that'll be at 7 o'clock here at the building. So if you're part of that group, please plan on coming tonight. We are planning that as the weather is getting nicer, we are planning to have some outdoor drive-in services, but we will let you know when the first service will take place. This week, they're forecasting rain, so we're not even thinking about that this week, but we're hoping to get some in before the weather gets too hot, and so we encourage you to keep watch, and we'll make sure that you are made aware of any drive-in services in plenty of time. We are attempting to take every precaution we can to keep our people safe during this time, and so we want to remind you that all health protocols will continue in effect. So please keep that in your mind. There's a couple of things I just want to say and share with you before we finish this little announcement. I know that this is a trying time and that many of you are struggling and it's getting you down and you've had enough. And I hear you. I am there myself. But let me share a verse that I have gone to many times over the course of my life. And even again yesterday, I went to it and read it and shared it last night during our prayer time. And that is Psalm 61 and verse 2, and in fact, the last part of verse 2. And some of you may already know it, but it says, "When my heart is overwhelmed, lead me to the rock that is higher than I." It reminded me of a quote that I heard from Charles Haddon Spurgeon. And Spurgeon said that, "I have learned to kiss the wave that threw me against the rock of ages." In other words, embrace the adversity that forces us to lean on Christ, because that ultimately is for our good. And so I encourage you to keep your eyes on Christ, stay in your word, the word of God. And in closing, let me share with you something I shared back a few months ago that Andrew Murray said in relationship to adversity. He said, "In times of trouble, say this: first, he brought me here. It is by his will that I am in this strait place. In that fact, I will rest. Next, He will keep me here in his love and give me grace to behave as his child. Then he will make the trial a blessing, teaching me the lessons he intends me to learn and working in me the grace he means to bestow. Last, in his good time, he can bring me out again. How and when, only he knows. So let me say, I am here, number one, by God's appointment. Number two, in his keeping. Number three, under his training. And number four, for his time, not ours. And so I hope that that blesses your heart just a little bit and encourages you in this day. We want you to know that we are here for you. Our ministry is going to continue unaffected. Our work for the kingdom does not depend upon laws made by God or by men. It depends on the Word of God and our commission. So we're going to continue to press forward and try to reach our community with the gospel and send missionaries around the world. And we look forward to seeing you this Sunday, Lord willing. If you're comfortable coming, we're comfortable having you. All right? God bless and have a great day. Goodbye for now.